In this tutorial, we are going to talk about algebraic fractions or rational expressions. It's very similar ideas. Now, here's examples of algebraic fractions. X over 2, x over y, and so on. So, actually, it's any fraction involving letters. It could be one letter, x or a, or it could be more than one letter. So, general overall form of an algebraic fraction is f of x over g of x, where f of x and g of x, any polynomials in terms of x or other variables. So again, algebraic fraction might have more than one variable. Now, let's focus on excluded values of algebraic fraction. Say we have algebraic fraction p of x over q of x. Now, excluded value or value, so it could be more than one actually, of the variable x, it's the values that make your denominator, the bottom of your fraction, undefined, equal to zero. So again, the value or values of x that make your denominator equals to zero are called excluded values. And the meaning of the excluded values you will see in a while. Now, how to find excluded values of given algebraic fractions? Say we have p of x over q of x. All you need to do is just make a list of all values of x when q of x is not equal to zero. So remember, q of x is the denominator of your fraction. Now, you take the bottom, in other words, of your fraction and set it not equal to zero. So q of x is not equal to zero, and you have to solve it for x. So the solution of this gives you the list of all excluded values. If you look at your algebraic fraction as a function, as a rational function in terms of x, so the process of finding the excluded values of the algebraic fraction is identical to find the domain of this rational function. So it's precisely the same idea. Now, let's have a look at example. Say we need to find the excluded values of x plus 2 over x. All you want to do is just grab this x from the denominator and set it not equal to 0. So this value of x, this 0, has to be thrown out from the domain of this function. Again, if you look at this as a function. So it has to be excluded values. Again, since this 0 makes this fraction undefined, so it creates this division by zero problem. Another example, say we have 3x minus 4 over x times x plus 1 times x minus 3. All you want to do is just grab the denominator, the entire bottom of this fraction, and since we have a product, you want to set each factor is not equal to zero. Again, we need to find the values of x that make your denominator equal to zero. Again, since division by zero is not permitted. So, x is not equal to zero. So, from the first one, the second factor, x plus 1, cannot be equal to zero. So, x is not equal to negative 1. And finally, from the third factor, x minus 3 is not equal to 0, so x cannot be equal to 3. So if you grab these values of x and plug it in into your fraction, you will get this division by 0 problem. Now, let's talk about simplifying algebraic fractions. Remember that algebra, it's all about simplifying. As far as we know, that normal numerical fractions can be simplified, reduced to its lowest term, by canceling out the common factors from top and bottom of the fraction. For instance, if we have 2 over 4, 2 and 4, they share the common factor, which is 2. So, dividing 2 and 4 by 2, this fraction simplifies to a half. So, the same idea can be applied to algebraic fractions. So also we want to make sure we get our algebraic fractions into simplest form possible by canceling out top and bottom. So say we have 15x squared over 10xy, and we have to simplify and state the excluded values of this fraction. So 15 and 10, the numerical coefficient, they have the highest common factor, which is 5, and also x goes on top and the bottom. So this fraction can be reduced by dividing top and bottom by 5x. So it's going to be 3x over 2y. And excluded values, x and y, cannot be equal to 0. Some problems to carry out. Let's move on to operations on algebraic fractions. The first one is multiplication. So two or more algebraic fractions can be multiplied together. Say we have p over q times r over s. All you want to do is just multiply top straight across, and you multiply bottom's denominator straight across, as you would do normal fractions. So provided that q and s, since their bottom's not equal to zero. The second one is the division. Say we have p over q and we need to divide it by r over s. Again, all you want to do is just keep the first fraction as is. Now, you want to swap division to multiplication. And for the second fraction, you want to flip top and bottom, so it becomes s over r. Again, you would do precisely the same as you would divide two numerical fractions. And again, provided that q and s is not equal to zero. Let's move on to the last, addition and subtraction. Two or more algebraic fractions can be added or subtracted as long as they have the common, the same denominator q in this case. So all you want to do is just add or subtract the numerators accordingly. Let's say we have to add 1 over x and 1 over x plus 1. Let's perform this operation. So again, you want to make sure you get the common denominator. So in this case, it's x times x plus 1. So you want to multiply the first fraction by x plus 1 over x plus 1. Remember, what you do to top, you have to do the same thing to bottom, in order you don't want to change the value of your fraction. And the second one, you are going to multiply by x over x. Now, the first, the top, becomes x plus 1 plus x. So you want to combine these two x's together. It becomes 2x plus 1 over x times x plus 1 brackets remains the same. So that's going to be the answer. Now, you could carry out this problem.